from the Technology Center on the campus of Herkimer College. This is HCTV News, a student-produced newscast covering Herkimer County and the community it serves.
Good evening, I'm Melissa Krall. Welcome to HCTV News from Herkimer College. We've been here every Thursday afternoon this semester at 5 o'clock with a full half-hour newscast produced by students enrolled in Communication Arts programs here at Herkimer. This is our last half-hour newscast of the semester. We'll be back again tomorrow night at 5 with a 15-minute edition. HCTV News is a production of advanced video production students enrolled in the Communication Arts Radio and Television Broadcasting program. At the end of last semester, students finished up their studies and exams and left Herkimer County Community College for their typical winter break. When they came back, though, it wasn't quite the school they had applied to. The school had rebranded itself entirely and renamed itself Herkimer College. Students were not alerted to this change and discovered it gradually. HCTV News was able to further investigate the rebranding and the reason behind it. This semester here on HCTV News, we've been keeping you updated about the recent rebranding of Herkimer College, which of course means that it's no longer referred to as HCCC, but Herkimer College. We decided to ask students here on the campus and some off-campus residents as well what they thought about the change. What are your thoughts on the recent rebranding of Herkimer College?
I most definitely like it. I believe it gives more professionalism to the name of it. You know, it's not just Herkimer County Community College, it's Herkimer College, you know, the state university. It just adds that better touch to it. You know, when you see your diploma, it's, you know, it's not just that community college, because that might get looked down upon in some areas.
Do you feel like it's a more professional name?
Yes, most definitely it's more professional, and it gives us a better look, you know, for someone who graduates from it.
The name change wasn't the only difference made from the rebranding. We also have a new Herkimer Generals logo. What do you think about that?
I like it. It's different, you know, it looks more inviting, you know, it looks more, you know, just better. It's much better. You know, it's not plain. It's definitely different, so I like it.
Feels more competitive.
Yes, most definitely. It gives our athletes something more to be motivated about.
Well, me being a resident, I feel like it's a really good thing, because not only does it help just the community, I feel like it helps students, that they feel like it's not just a community college that they won't get recognized for. I feel like it'll probably make Herkimer thrive a little bit more and flourish with more people wanting to come here. And I feel like that's a good thing, because everyone needs education and not just a high school diploma.
Students aren't the only ones voicing their opinions about the recent rebranding of Herkimer College. Faculty members have something to say too.
I think the rebranding is great. It's going to take a couple years to increase retention, but in the big picture, we will be more prominent around not only New York State, but the country, in the United States, to international students, to every type of student. It'll just be more popular, and we will be now on the list with colleges such as Yale or bigger SUNY schools.
Work on the rebranding of Herkimer College continues. One of the many upcoming efforts involves the planning and execution of a virtual tour of the campus and its facilities. That project is currently underway. Alongside the variety of other end-of-year events being held throughout these final days of the semester, the 37th annual Poobie Awards are coming up too. The ceremony will be held right here in Herkimer College's TV studio next Tuesday, May 6th. The awards were originally given out strictly for the production of public service announcements, and the event has grown along with the college. The awards now recognize students from all communication arts majors at Herkimer College, including music industry, radio TV broadcasting, new media, and digital filmmaking. Students will be rewarded for their produced videos, audio and music content, as well as for exceptional success in producing, directing, media writing, and other media major related activities and content. The event is open to the public. Coming next Tuesday, after experiencing a lapse in publication, Herkimer College's formerly annual literary magazine, Phaethon, will be seeing a rebirth. The publication features student-created art in the forms of photographs, poetry, and an array of other types of art. The book, which was compiled by a group of Herkimer students, was brought to fruition under direction from Herkimer professor Blake Pitcher.
Fayathon is the arts and literary publication of Herkimer College. It's being revived this year, along with myself and advisors Andrew Devitt and Matt Powers, and it represents a diverse collection of work from across the Herkimer College community. There's a diverse contribution base. We have emeriti, students, staff, so it really represents a nice wide array of different visions. Next Tuesday at the College Library at 12:30, we'll be having a little launch party, and everyone's welcome to stop by, and the people who are contributing will be able to get their first copies of the Fayathon. I'd just like to say it was a great experience working with the other advisors, and I'm really proud of the work our student editors did. It looks really sharp, and I think it's going to be well received in the campus community.
Here it is, the first Fayathon book. You can check it out at their launch party that's set for next Tuesday, May 6th, on the second floor patio of the college library from 12:30 to 1:30. Refreshments and copies of the publication will both be available. The event will be held inside the library in the event of inclement weather. While we're on the topic of health, we've got another Herc Health tip for you today on HCTV News. The end of the semester can often keep students indoors to study and prepare for exams, but it's very important for us to exercise in order to stay in good health. Coordinator of Creating Healthy Places in Herkimer County, Allison Swartz, tells us about a hidden gem of the area, Herkimer's trail systems.
This time of year, now that the snow has thawed and spring has sprung, it's great to take advantage of local trails and local playgrounds and take in some physical activity right here in your own backyard. This great Herkimer County Trails Guide provides information about 20 different trails from the Mohawk Valley to the Adirondacks. They could pick them up right on North Main Street, actually 320 North Main Street at Herkimer County Health Net. Downtown Herkimer.
Thanks to Allison Swartz for that great health tip. And here's a reminder to just not keep this time of year keeping you indoors. There's more news straight ahead after this break during HCTV News. I'm Melissa Krall. Brady Lawrence will join us after the break. He's up next with your complete weather forecast. Stay with us.
Coming up next, the weather outlook for Herkimer and the surrounding areas here on HCTV News. Stay with us.
The Herkimer College Music Industry Program returns to the Tramontane Cafe on Friday, May 2nd. It's Murph's Rock and Roll Circus live at the Tram.
Murph.
Acoustic tunes from Billy Muha.
Murph.
Intricate improv jams from Copper Vein Clones. And raucous progressive rock and roll from Jason Davis and the New Philosopher.
Murph.
The Tram serves coffee and food. Bands associated with the Herkimer College Music Industry Program serve up the tune. Murph's Rock and Roll Circus.
Murph.
Live music at the Tram on Lincoln Ave in Utica, May 2nd. Brought to you by the Herkimer College Music Club.
Jump into the world of radio production and electronic media at Herkimer County Community College's 91.5 FM WVHC. When the semester kicks in, students take over the airwaves, turning their dreams and ideas into real live radio.
Topping Herkimer County Community College news today with graduation soon approaching.
Are you the next big voice? Find your home on the airwaves at Herkimer County Community College and WVHC. For more information, go to www.herkimer.edu.
Families come in all sizes and shapes. Sometimes your friends are your family by choice, or sometimes you're just stuck with Uncle Charles. Sometimes you've got an office family.
Yes!
And sometimes team family has got your back. But what we know is that you want to protect the people that are close to you. The flu can unravel everything. Your flu vaccine protects you and your family. No matter what draws your family together, protect yourself. Protect your family. Everyone needs a flu vaccine.
Now, the weather outlook for Herkimer and the surrounding areas here on HCTV News.
Welcome back to HCTV News from Herkimer College. I'm Melissa Krall.
And I'm Brady Lawrence for HCTV News Weather.
Brady, another rainy day out there.
Yeah, unfortunately, there's going to be a lot of rain coming our way pretty soon. But the good news is it's not snow. So
yeah, exactly.
Let's take a look at our current conditions, brought to you by weatherunderground.com. As you can see, there's a little bit of precipitation coming up into the northeast. Some of it will go through Utica, as you can see, Utica-Rome area. We're going to be pounded with some rain showers in the coming days. So let's take a look at tonight. It's going to be 41 degrees with the rain showers, as I mentioned, with winds traveling northwest at 7 miles per hour. Tomorrow, it's going to be 59 degrees with the same showers and winds traveling west at 5 to 13 miles per hour. And then Saturday, 59 degrees. Still some showers. You got to be a little patient. They'll start to dissipate next week. Winds at 4 to 7 miles per hour going towards the west. And let's take a look at your extended, Sunday. 56 degrees with some rain showers as well. Winds going southwest, 4 to 7 miles per hour. Now let's take a look at your extended outlook. Monday, we're going to have a high of 52 and a low of 35. Tuesday, partly cloudy with a high of 58 and a low of 36. And Wednesday, also partly cloudy, but it's starting to warm up in midweek, 65 with a low of 44.
I can remember earlier this week on HCTV News in the extended outlook, it was rain every single day. At least now it's partly sunny every single day.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's going to be rainy for the next couple of days. But next week, it'll start to clear up a little bit. Very low chances of rain those days, and hopefully the week after will be sunny.
So just get through this week and then clear skies. Yeah. All right, well, thank you for that weather update. When we return, Sean McCumber will catch us up on the latest regarding the Herkimer Generals sports teams. Stay with us.
Catch up with the Herkimer Generals sports teams. After the break, it's Sports Wrap here on HCTV News.
Make the right connections with your communication arts degree from Herkimer College. Interested in radio? Meant to DJ? Then Herkimer College's radio TV program is the program for you. Learn all about the radio industry, record your own show, or even produce a live one. The possibilities are endless. For more information about communication arts programs at Herkimer College, visit www.herkimer.edu.
I never get the flu.
My kids don't need more shots.
I don't have time.
We're all healthy.
No matter how you build your excuses, the flu can blow your house down.
I can't believe I used up all my sick time.
I missed a week of school during finals.
Now my baby has it because of me.
The hospital?
Keep your foundation strong. Vaccinate.
Hello everyone, I'm Sean McCumber bringing you this week's edition of Sports Wrap here on HCTV News. It has been a busy week for the general sports teams here at Herkimer. Let's get you caught up. The men's tennis team went up against SUNY Delhi Broncos this past Saturday, where Jacob Toher and Austin Davis won doubles 8-3. This has been the Generals' first win for the tennis season. During HCTV News' Sports Minute, we talked about the men's tennis match against SUNY Adirondack and said that we would have more information on the game during tonight's edition of Sports Wrap. The game was canceled on account of rain, along with the match that was scheduled for Tuesday against Broome Community College. These games were the last games that the Generals tennis team had scheduled for the rest of the semester. Moving on to men's baseball, the Generals traveled to Troy on Sunday to take on Hudson Valley Community College. The Generals split a doubleheader, winning game number one and taking a loss for game two. In game one, the Generals won against the Vikings, 11-1. Kyle Garrison earned the game victory to move 4-1 on the season. Garrison allowed 4 hits and 1 run. He threw 2 strikeouts over 6 innings. In game number two, Herkimer lost to the Vikings 2-1. Rob Hardy was the driving force for the Generals, working 5 innings and only allowing 3 hits. The Vikings got on board with the 4th inning when Bradley Adams hit a high changeup for a double to take 1-0 lead. Hudson responded in the 6th and got a big RBI hit from Scotia to take 2-1 lead. On Tuesday, the Herkimer Generals came home to take on rival team Mohawk Valley Community College, where they were victorious in their doubleheaders against MVCC. In game one, the Generals played on a wet and windy day, but Michael Harrington used the foul weather to his advantage. Harrington threw the entire game, but only allowing one run on two hits, riding a no-hitter through the sixth inning. The Hawks came back with a double to start off the seventh inning. They eventually went to score. With a sacrificed bunt. Herkimer scored on game one with close score of 2-1. In game number two, the conditions of the field affected both teams offensively and defensively. MVCC Hawks hit an error in the first inning where they took the lead. The Generals, running out of time and outs, managed to tie the game in the seventh, but the game went into extra innings due to a walk from Taishi Terashima. Herkimer needed three batters to come to the plate to decide the outcome of the game. Fabrizio's only hit of the game was the winning hit to score the Generals their game two point. Game two also ended similarly to game one, with the Generals ending with a score similar with 2-1. The Herkimer's away baseball game that was scheduled against Mohawk Valley Community College for today was canceled on account of weather. The Generals baseball team's next game will be on May 3rd. It will be a home game against Columbia Green Community College starting at noon. Well, there's this week's edition of Sports Wrap. I'm Sean McCumber. Stay tuned. You're watching HCTV News. We'll be back after this.
Children intake poison. Would you?
Now for the HCTV News Question of the Week. It's your turn to express your thoughts on campus-wide issues.
Hello and welcome back to HCTV News here on HCTV. I'm Melissa Kroll. Thank you for joining us. Time now for our HCTV News Question of the Week, where we search the campus looking for your on-camera input. The topic currently on the mind of most people on campus, even us here at HCTV News, is the end of another school year. For the members of RT-263, this means graduation and the future. Chris Klausner talked to the members of Herkimer's Advanced Video Production class to see what we have in mind for our futures after Herkimer.
I'm Chris Klausner with HCTV News Question of the Week. This week we ask our very own HCTV News crew their plans after the semester.
After graduation, my plans, I currently don't I would like to go to a different college, but currently don't have one in mind. I'm currently looking through several different colleges. I'm going to start applying to some. It might be a little late, but maybe I'll get to the next semester, and I'll just kind of go from there. I'll just kind of work and see where I'm going to go with my college search, because I would at least like to get my bachelor's. So, yeah.
My plans after this semester, well, I'm actually graduating from Herkimer College, and I do work part-time at WUTR right now, and I think that I'm just going to stay there and continue hosting Hello Central New York and producing it and getting to know the community. It's a great community, and I'm not ready to leave yet, so those are my plans.
Oh, my plans for after the semester, I'm going to keep working at WUTR, where I've been working for about a year now. It's good experience in the industry. I'm coming back to Herkimer in the fall for one more semester, and then I'm not quite sure where I want to transfer to from there, but I definitely want to go on to get my bachelor's in either broadcasting or switch my major to something like political science. But yeah, those are pretty much my plans for after the semester.
Well, hopefully this fall,
provided that I graduate, which is still up in the air, obviously, because the semester hasn't completely ended. I intend to go to SUNY Plattsburgh. I already paid my deposit. And I think my major is going to be broadcast journalism. And I'm just hoping to progress in my school life and hopefully find a good job that gets me a decent amount of hours and make money, because everyone likes money.
And that's it for our last question of the week of the semester. I'm Chris Klausner. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Chris. That's our final question of the week for this semester's Thursday's newscast. And we'd like to thank everyone who has spoken with us over the weeks. Well, stay with us. Coming up after the break, Sean McCumber will be talking to Herkimer College's Director of Student Activities, Vicki Brown, about the many end-of-year semester activities held by the Center for Student Leadership and Involvement. That's straight ahead in our Newsmakers segment right here on HCTV News. Stay with us.
Peaceful, calm, full of natural beauty, the Adirondack Park in upstate New York is the place for your outdoor adventures. Take a leisurely stroll as you browse the shops of scenic Old Forge. Take a dinner cruise along historic lakes. Boats depart at various times throughout the day from Old Forge Pond. Or head deep into the Adirondacks for a true wilderness experience. Set up at your own private campsite. Build a roaring fire. Take a relaxing canoe ride. Enjoy the natural splendor that's just up the road. The Adirondack Park, where you can get away from it all without going too far away. Are you ready to go? Then go ahead and visit www.apa.state.ny.us for details regarding your next Adirondack adventure.
Hello and welcome back to HCTV News. I'm Melissa Krall. Thank you for joining us. This is a 30-minute newscast produced by Herkimer College Communication Arts, Radio, Television, Broadcasting majors. This live weekly newscast is a production of RT263, an advanced video production class offered here at Herkimer College. Right now, Sean McCumber is interviewing Vicki Brown, Director of Student Activities here at Herkimer College. This is our live Newsmakers segment. Sean?
Thanks, Melissa. I'm Sean McCumber. Welcome to Newsmakers. As Melissa said, I am interviewing Vicki Brown, Director of Student Activities from the Center of Student Leadership and Involvement. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic. I got these little note cards, what I want to ask you. Starting off, you did change the name from the center to, it was originally Student Activities. Why did we make this change?
Correct. Well, the word Student Activities is very old-fashioned, and it didn't really fully capture all that our office does. Right. So we proposed for the name change, and the powers that be chose the Center for Student Leadership and Involvement, which better explains what our office does.
It really captures all the stuff.
Correct.
So with only the last couple of days of the semester, what do we have lined up for activities?
Yeah, we have a lot of things going on, especially next week. On Tuesday, we're having an event called Herkimer in Color, and it's a dance party that'll be hosted outside the campus meadows, and it's just an event for students to come. Don't wear your best clothes, because there'll be paint everywhere.
Oh.
And it was supposed to be tonight, but because of the weather, we had to change it to next Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
So next Tuesday at 7 o'clock in campus meadows is our Herkimer in Color event.
Okay.
And then on Wednesday, we have three different events going on. We have the Stressless Caribbean Getaway, and that'll be from 11 to 2 in the RMCC lobby. We have a mechanical surfboard, hair wrapping, and the smoothie bar. Yes, it's going to be a lot of fun. I think students are really looking forward to it.
Mm-hmm.
And then that evening, we have Merp Stock, which is a concert put on by our music club. And that'll be from 5 to 10 in one of our theaters.
Mm-hmm.
And then to finish off the last day of classes, we have a free breakfast for students starting at 10 o'clock in the cafeteria.
Oh, that just sounds delicious.
Yeah, it should be.
Breakfast is like my favorite meal of the day. Mm-hmm. So that's, I make sure I have breakfast every morning. So.
Well, you can finish it at night too. So there you go.
Yeah. Start the day with it and end the day with it.
That's definitely.
All right. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we're going to cut to break, but we're going to come back with more Newsmakers after this. See you then.
When you call 911, you want a trained emergency medical professional to take care of you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Emergency Medical Services is a community effort. That's why we want you to join our team. Consider becoming an emergency medical technician. Pull over when an ambulance is approaching. learn CPR. Urge your elected officials to support emergency medical services. Together, we can save lives.
3875. Ah, there's nothing like the changing of the seasons. The waterways are less crowded. The temperatures are colder. And for many unprepared or inexperienced boaters, it's the perfect opportunity to set sail, dip paddle, or let that motor rip. But there's one thing that never changes, regardless of the season, and that's always remembering to wear a life jacket. A message from the New York State Office of Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation.
Welcome back to Newsmakers. I'm your host, Sean McCumber, and I'm here with Vicki Brown, the Director of Student Activities from the Center for Student Leadership and Involvement. Before the break, we were talking about activities for the end of the semester. Mm-hmm. But what are some things we have lined up for next semester?
Well, believe it or not, we are planning for the fall. We mm-hmm. always are planning about 6 months in advance.
Crazy.
So we already have some things in the works. Mm-hmm. We are looking to bring in the Balloon Man, who makes a lot of different characters and like face masks out of balloons.
That sounds uncomfortable.
Yeah, he's really, it's pretty interesting. He's very creative and he's very quick.
Yeah.
So he'll make a lot of creations. Last time we had him on campus, he made penguins. He made an Elmo, he made a monster face, Cookie Monster,
like
all out of balloons.
Ago,
he was,
yeah.
So we're bringing him back because students really enjoyed mm-hmm. that. We're also doing an event called Take Home Tuesdays, where we do a different event every Tuesday, the first Tuesday of every month.
Mm-hmm.
And we're looking at making your own bracelets, spin art, frisbee, and sunglasses.
That sounds
we're bringing
cool.
back the Trekker airbrush hats that students really enjoyed, so we'll be bringing that back. And we're also already planning Fall Fest and Alumni Weekend, which will be the first weekend in October.
That's pretty far ahead.
Yes.
So, yeah. All right. You met with the new student ambassadors a couple days ago.
We did, yes. And our student ambassadors, we hire them every year to help us out with orientation, mm-hmm. Fall Fest Alumni Weekend, and open houses.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So they just kind of help around and they do like open house and stuff?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And yesterday was the Phi Theta Kappa induction ceremony.
Yes, we inducted 67 new members into Phi Theta Kappa.
Which that's
is
impressive.
Which is an international honor society.
Yeah, I was there.
I know.
Yes, I was there. It was pretty crazy. Sometimes it didn't know what to do, but yeah. All right, so that's all the time we have for this segment of our last segment, actually, for Newsmakers for this semester. So I'm going to throw it back to Melissa, who's going to end this show off. Melissa.
Thanks, Sean. And before we go, we do have Brady here for one last look at the weather. Brady, what can we expect tonight?
Well, as I said earlier, it's going to be rainy. Not too warm, not too cold tonight. You might just need a light jacket, 41 degrees. Some showers and winds going northwest at 7 miles per hour. Oh, and tomorrow, it's going to be 59 degrees with those same showers lingering through until tomorrow. Winds moving west at 5 to 13 miles per hour.
And I think we were talking about it earlier, no one out there in that weather shot.
Yeah, there's no one out there right now. I guess they're staying inside. It's probably the best
smart.
Move for tonight.
Yeah, exactly. Well, they'd have to be inside to watch our broadcast, so it makes sense. Thanks again for that weather update, Brady. That wraps up our last full 30-minute newscast of the semester and leaves only one final newscast overall, which you can catch here on HCTV tomorrow night at 5. Just a reminder, newscasts are also archived on our YouTube channel, and you can find us on Facebook. For more details on the communication arts programs offered at Herkimer College, visit www.herkimer.edu/learn. For everyone here in the communication arts programs at Herkimer College, I'm Melissa Krall.
And I'm Brady Lawrence.
Thanks for watching HCTV News. We'll see you again tomorrow night at 5 for our final newscast of the semester. We hope you'll join us.